Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you are in the world. Thank you so much for stopping by. My name is Aisha Tadewoyi, and in today's video we are going to talk about how you can sign up for Alipay account. Actually, the reason I'm doing this is that if you want to picture search on 1688.com, picture searching with normal desktop sites doing all this thing is not that easy these days because people are having problem with it, and that's why I think putting you through the right way to actually have your own account, have your own Alipay account, use it to sign in 1688.com. This will make things easier for you, and also this will help you to be able to pay your supplier in China. You want to just something on 1688 and you need to use your Alipay account to pay on 1688, this will also help you. You will not need to send a link to someone or use an agent or be struggling for all this and that. Sometimes your agent may be busy, they'll keep you for too long, and these are the disadvantages of using an agent. This video, I will actually want to put you through what you can do and the right way to do it, also using it to sign in into 1688.com. That's what we are doing today, and thank you for staying with me. I have to go into the phone to record whatever we have for today. This is my Alipay now. I want to sign up for a new account. There are so many advantages for logging into your 1688.com. You get to buy your products yourself. You will not need anybody to buy for you. If you are able to sign in and you have your Alipay accounts running, you'll be able to pay yourself. You'll be able to save products. Maybe like you want to add products to your favorites, you'll be able to do that. You'll be able to speak with the seller. You can easily talk to the seller. You can chat with them with Ali Wang Wang. Once you do that, they will reply you and things will be fine. But unless you log in, you cannot add anything to your favorite, you cannot speak with the seller, and that's how it works. Except there is only one way you can do it. If you know you did not log in or you don't have any login detail, you can only do that through WeChat. You take the person's phone number, and we are still going there. You take the seller's phone number and chat them off 1688.com. So let's continue with our signing up. To change your area code, click on the area code, then change it to Nigeria. If you are in Nigeria, if you are in Ghana, change it to Ghana. Anywhere you are, change it to your country code. I'm checking for my own country now. Good. It's asking me to enter my mobile number. Fine. So you sign up, click on sign up. It will ask you, do you agree? This is their terms and conditions. Click on agree. Then now it will send code to your phone. Code. Once you type in the code, your account will be created. So this is my page now. I've signed up and this is my page. Send the code to you and they've created your account like this, but you need a password because next time when you want to log in, you will need your password. So this is the way to go about it. Go to settings. Once you're in settings, go to account security. Click on account and security. Click on login password. You want to create your login password. So you can change your login password. Click on change now. Then type in login password you like. Click on the login password. Then save. Click on save. It says, remember that this is the only password you will use to log into your Taobao account, TB53 something something, and your Alipay account.
confirm. So you confirm it. Once you have your login password with you, come back here. Click on nickname on set. Once you click on it, you'll be able to see your Taobao account. This Taobao account you are seeing here. I'm here in the website and I want to log in. You click on login. This login, click on it. Look out for this 1688 something. This is where you click, not the other side. Click on it. Then once you click on it, click on this again. Now you will go to your Alipay. This old number TB5 is what you will go and type in there. Once you type it in, click on this to log in. So once you are here, it will want to confirm if it's really you or someone else. So it will ask you that you should check your phone for verification code. Now click on get SMS verification code. Then it will send verification code to your phone. Once you receive the verification code, because the verification code will look like it will be filled with too many Chinese language, but use type in the number you can see there and then click on next step. So that's all, you are here. For some people, it may display something like for you to be entering your name, your address. Don't mind it, just close that place down and come to your normal page. This is how it's supposed to be. So now I can go to mine. So now I want to explain something about this mine for us. This pending payments is where you will be able to see your product that you have not paid for. To be delivered is where you'll be able to see the products that they will soon get delivered. You've paid for it, it will move to be delivered. To be received, once they have already packaged your goods and they have sent it out, and the seller has assigned that they have already sent it out, it will be able to display that you are about to receive the goods. After receiving the goods for some days, it will come to comment so that you'll be able to comment. Let's now say it did not move from pending payment. It did not move from to be delivered. It has been in to be delivered for like 5 days. What you can do is for you to make sure you ask for refund.